Which Succession actor almost missed his audition? Why does Jeremy Strong drive Brian Cox crazy? And how's the show linked to the British royal family? Hi, I'm Dylan, and you're watching Awesome Movies. Let's get started. Real life inspiration? A family behind a groundbreaking media empire, a founding CEO in his 80s who refuses to retire. You needn't look very far to see where the writers of Succession may have found inspiration for the Roy family. It's been widely reported that Succession is loosely based on real-life Murdoch media dynasty. Patriarch Robert Murdoch is the man behind mass media and publishing company News Corp. Over the years, he's involved all four of his children in the company's various holdings. Yet, at 89, he remains executive chairman and is yet to pass on the reins. Yet the Murdochs are not the only family who compares. Succession's writers reportedly also look to the Redstones and the Hursts, both families behind giant media conglomerates. They even discussed Queen Elizabeth and her son Prince Charles, who has waited his entire life to ascend to the throne. Making it up as they go along? Of course there's a script, but sometimes there's no plan at all. Succession's actors are often encouraged to take their own initiative. In fact, Kendall's bathroom breakdown after he finds out he's not immediately taking over the company in the show's pilot episode was entirely improvised. Actor Jeremy Strong simply followed his instincts. That's a great example of the process of this show, which director Adam McKay established and is a way that I prefer to work, he told Variety, which is to have no plan at all and to discover the scene while you're doing it, not rehearse. After Strong basically attacked the bathroom objects, he landed up cleaning the mess on the floor, something he hadn't planned. I made this mess and then I realized that I couldn't leave this mess, he says. Having recently taken home an acting Emmy for his role, Strong's performance was anything but messy. Armstrong strongly endorses Succession's spirit of improvisation, having them all around a dinner table and having a couple cameras running and saying, "Do the script, but then do some bits around it. I love that way of shooting," he told Thrillist. He says it allows the cast to be more comedic, which he thinks works really well for a drama like Succession. Kieran Culkin as Cousin Greg. Kieran Culkin was initially asked to audition for the role of Cousin Greg, which to us just feels wrong. Luckily, he immediately realized that he was much better suited for the role of the youngest Roy sibling, Roman. "I saw that he was kinda horrible and I immediately loved his voice," said Culkin, recounting the story on PBS series Actors on Actors. Yet the auditions for the role of Roman had already closed. Culkin sent in a tape anyway and producers agreed that they'd found their Roman. "There was something that clicked with me in this character that's something I still don't understand, and probably don't want to understand considering the kind of guy he is," he told The Hollywood Reporter. Yet he was undeniably on the money. And in a further case of perfect casting, Nicholas Braun, who ultimately landed the role of Cousin Greg, is said to be the actor who's most like the character he portrays. And yes, he really is that tall, 6'7" to be exact. While he's been acting his whole life, Culkin says that Succession is the show that's proved that he actually wants to be an actor. Initially in the shadow of his brother Macaulay, the most famous child star of the 90s, Kieran was thrust into showbiz. In his 20s, he realized he never actually made the decision to be an actor, so he took an extended acting sabbatical. Succession was a turning point. "We were shooting last season when I came home one day and I said, I think this is what I want to do," he told The Guardian. Unlikely auditions. Culkin's not the only cast member whose audition didn't quite go according to plan. Alan Ruck, aka Connor Roy, almost missed his altogether. Home for the weekend with his wife and kids for the first time in ages, Ruck felt that he couldn't abandon his family commitments, so he took his son to music class instead. Whoa, not a lot of actors would make that call. Ruck proved that doing the right thing pays off though. He came out of the kiddie music class to find 7 phone messages telling him to go to Adam McKay's house. "So I went and I had an off-the-cuff audition for Adam in his home and then they cast me later that day," Ruck told Collider. Strong, who had previously worked with McKay in Oscar-winning movie The Big Short, heard about the show whilst having lunch at McKay's house. McKay asked him to read the script and see who he connected to. "Clearly the takeaway here is you have to go to Adam McKay's house and opportunities will rain down," Strong joked at a 2019 Deadline HBO Awards season event. Fun fact, in real life, Ruck is only 10 years younger than Brian Cox, the man who plays his father. Ruck's character is 10 years younger than the actor himself, while Cox's is 10 years older than he really is. As for Australian actress Sarah Snook, aka Shiv Roy, she was so certain that she wouldn't get the part that she wasn't even nervous for her audition. "I really was just like, nah, this is out of my league. I'll just come and do it and get out of here. Free trip to LA for a weekend and see my friends," she told GQ. Funny how things work out. Cast clashes? While the cast respect one another greatly, there's reportedly an every man for himself atmosphere on set. But it has less to do with how the actors feel about each other and more about how their characters are constructed. It helps me believe in the reality of the circumstances, Strong told Variety. While we were cordial and friendly, and I have a great deal of love and respect for all the actors on the show, I tended to keep a distance and felt quite remote. In fact, this distance may sometimes have driven Brian Cox nuts, says Strong. Brian and I will often not rehearse at all, he says, speaking to the rap. We certainly won't talk about the scene, we'll just do it on camera. And we do it on film, which adds rigor and feels dangerous. That scene on the boat, we started to rehearse and we were losing the light, Strong recalls. I felt strongly that we shouldn't release any tension that I felt I had by rehearsing it. So I stopped the rehearsal, to Brian's consternation. Yet Strong has nothing but praise for Cox, who he calls a force of nature. Both actors also share theater backgrounds, which is likely why their off-the-cuff scenes are so powerful. Brian Cox was too compelling to be killed off. Cox's character Logan Roy was originally meant to be killed off in season 1 of the show. That was so he could leave his family battling out who would become his heir to the family business. Cox was fine with that, but after chatting with Armstrong and McKay about the lifespan of his character, they decided to save his life, so to speak. He was just too compelling a character to lose. Cox apparently fought for Logan to have a similar roots to his own. When he initially suggested to McKay and Armstrong that Logan hail from his own birthplace of Dundee in Scotland, the idea was nixed. Yet on the 9th episode, Cox found out they'd added the Dundee backstory after all, as a surprise for him. In season 2, the show in fact explores this part of the story, with Cox traveling home to Dundee with the cast to record 2 episodes. Secrets from the set. Largely shot in New York to add authenticity, Succession uses some of the city's well-known landmarks. The family's business, Waystar Royco, is located in One World Trade Center, the tallest building in the USA. While interior scenes are generally shot on a soundstage, exterior scenes are shot in some empty office space near the top of the tower. The views from Logan Roy's magnificent apartment were also shot from empty condos on Billionaire's Row. That's why the Met and Central Park are visible from his windows. Yet the exterior shots of his building come from an apartment block on Fifth Avenue, and the home's interior was built on a set in Long Island City's Silver Cup Studios. Another fun fact? Shiv's wedding was in a real fairy tale location. Cast and crew traveled to England to film the scenes in East Nor Castle. COVID-19 has posed challenges when it comes to filming the hotly anticipated third season of the show. Filming had to be delayed due to the pandemic, and to date is yet to begin. The team reportedly hopes to begin filming in November. Regardless of whether or not this is possible, Brian Cox predicts that season 3 will look a little different. That's due to the show's unique filming style, which is likely to be disrupted. We shoot on the move and chronologically, Cox told Variety. But we now have to change in a way to be more controlled. We'll have to use more sets than we did before, he predicted. Drama meets comedy. Why is Succession, which recently won the Emmy for Outstanding Drama Series, so connected to the world of comedy? One of the darkly comic drama series executive producers is none other than Hollywood funny man Will Ferrell. Together with Succession's co-executive producer and director, Adam McKay, Ferrell has produced such comedies as the Anchorman movies and Talladega Nights. The two met when they were hired on Saturday Night Live on the same day and later formed a production company, Gary Sanchez Productions. While they mutually decided to fold the company in 2019, the two remain friends and exec producers on Succession. Yet McKay says these films aren't as far apart from the series as many may think. They're all tied to a certain point of view and are expressions of how the world works, he told the Philadelphia Inquirer. People like to think of comedy and drama and horror as all these very different things, but they're really not, he said. They're much closer than we all think. Ferrell and McKay are not the only ones with comedy links. Jesse Armstrong is a known comedy writer who co-created British cult comedy Peep Show. And Alan Rich, another Succession executive producer, is one of the execs behind award-winning comedy show Veep. Armstrong, in fact, was also a writer on Veep's first season. Which behind-the-scenes fact do you find most surprising? Tell us in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Stay awesome!